Welcome to the press center of the FIDE World Chess Grand Prix in Sharjah. Here with us are Hikaru Nakamura and Hammer. The game ended in a draw. Can you please share some impressions about the game? It was not very long.
Yeah, no, it wasn't very long. I think I have like 6 or 7 straight losses against Hikaru.
You mentioned this
yesterday. Yeah, I really didn't want to repeat that. So I decided to play it very safe and then basically hope that he would do something silly.
God, what's your comment?
Yeah, no, I mean, I would agree. I mean, actually before the game I was thinking about doing something silly, but then, you know, I saw a few games that Jan Ludvig played against Magnus, I think, and okay, I mean, he won the one in 2015, obviously, in Norway, and then I saw some other ones, and okay, maybe the results weren't great, but he still got great positions, so I mean, I didn't feel like being stupid, you know, like Magnus.
Okay. Jan, can you just briefly show us what
was
the game?
Yeah, it was a Queen's Indian, which is a bit of a surprise to me. It was not one of the openings I was expecting. So after this knight e4, I had this spur of the moment. Normally I go bishop d2, which is the main line. And it's probably the one white should play if he's trying to prove an objective advantage. But instead, I decided to exchange this knight and go for a more simplified position, which is when you're on bad form, it's smart playing it simple. And also, I thought if Hikaru is too aggressive, this might be a position better suited for me than a position with every single piece on the board.
In the first 2 rounds, you made 2 draws with 2 of the highest rated players. What are the expectations for the remaining rounds?
I'm playing it cynically. I'm picking my opponents carefully, and I'm hoping to win some games. But I'm gonna try to win when it's not Sasha or Hikaru on the other side of the board.
Okay, Hikaru, in the previous cycle you qualified for the Cannes tournaments through the Grand Prix, but it was a different format. It was round robin tournaments. This one is Swiss system, but you also proved that you're expert in Swiss system by winning 3 Gibraltar Masters in a row. So
yeah, I mean, okay. Obviously, I want to finish top 2. I mean, I think that's the main reason for playing this, at least for me. But okay, it's very early. I mean, we're in the first event, first of all, and I mean, it's only 2 rounds. So I mean, it's kind of a little bit silly to take big risks at this point in time. You know, I mean, I was thinking. I think in the last Grand Prix of the last cycle, I think I was in third place or something behind Tomaszewski, and I think I drew my first 6 games, and then in the middle, towards the end, I won 2 games in a row, and that was enough to qualify. So I mean, I think it's important to figure out when to take the risk. And I mean, okay, it's so early that I think it's kind of stupid to do anything silly right now. I mean, if it's at the end and, you know, a loss doesn't matter, then it's a whole different thing. I mean, but so early, there's no need to go crazy.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.